Hello and welcome to Literary Love Connection, the Public Library of Youngstown and Mahoning County show that connects readers with their perfect literary match. My name is Tracy and I am your host today. We have three panelists. Each has chosen a book, read, and would like to recommend. Our lucky contestant asked five questions about these books. Our panelists give clever answers while keeping their choice anonymous. Based on the responses, our contestant chooses one book that will be their next great read. All right, let me introduce today's panelists. Please introduce yourself and tell us, name one of your favorite books that has a great location in your story, and where was that location? First, we'll go with Star. Hi, Star.
Hello, I'm a librarian in Austintown, and I have a hard time with questions like your favorite book because I have a hard time picking mine. But when I thought about a book that I love that had a really great place, I have to go with Harry Potter, because what's a better place than Hogwarts? I mean, the stairs moves, it's magical, it has ceilings with candles that float. I mean, it's the best.
One of my favorites by far. Next, we have Sarah. Hi, Sarah.
Hi, I'm a huge fantasy fiction fan. And when you ask this question, it's like, I was trying to think, did I have to pick a place that existed in our world or not? And I finally went with my really favorite things. I'm a superb, super fan of Anne McCaffrey's Pern books, and I stuck with Dragon Song. It's got a great location at one spot where there's a beach and a little cave in the beach that the one character's in, and she's helping to hatch and raise fire dragons, these flying miniature fire dragons, and just, you can't beat it.
It sounds magical, Sarah. And third, we have Amanda. Hi, Amanda.
Hi, I'm currently at the Struthers Library, and one of the first books I thought of with this question, a classic book, read quite a while ago, but the setting kind of still stays with me, and that is Rebecca. And it takes place off the coast of England, the wilds of Cornwall, which is a great setting in itself, but there's also this country estate, a grand imposing house. It's a large part of the book. So yes, that setting has always kind of stayed with me.
Wonderful setting. I think I'd like to read that book. Thank you, panelists. Now it's time to meet today's contestant. Welcome, Jessica. Please tell us a little bit about yourself and what you like to read.
Hi, I'm Jessica. I'm a clerk at the Austintown branch. I like all sorts of things. Mostly I read nonfiction, which can bore most people, but fiction I love too. And I would also say Harry Potter is like one of my favorite children's books.
Excellent. Okay, it's great to have you here, Jessica. Is everyone ready to play the game? Great. Jessica, please ask your first question.
Okay. If your book was an adventure, where would it take me?
So imagine a river with a really strong current, and you have a nice kayak, and you have to battle the raging river in your kayak.
That sounds like something I would like.
Right. That's the adventure my book would take you. Think of it that way.
All right, so if my adventure is going to be an adventure into another world, a magical world where magic and science coexist, and you have an empire of good and bad people, so you've got this adventure into this whole other world, and conspiracies and spies are abundant.
Oh. Right. This question was a little bit tough with the kind of book that I have. I will say it would probably be a kind of rocky adventure. Probably not the happiest adventure. and you might not know what's going to happen next, and you might not be able to trust everyone that you're on this adventure with.
Ooh, wow, that sounds really intriguing. Not being able to trust anybody? Ooh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Jessica, are you ready for question number two?
Sure. Okay, if your book was a song, which genre would it belong in?
So I'm going to say Irish ballads, which is kind of weird, but...
Okay, we can go with some Irish ballads.
Mine fits more with the folk music category, particularly the protest songs. The one that came to mind to kind of compare it to would be the If I Had a Hammer by Pete Seeger and Lee Hayes that was sung by Peter, Paul, and Mary.
Oh. Okay. Your book's in a whole bunch of different directions right now. I'm not really sure what I'm looking forward to here.
And mine would probably be like a movie soundtrack. It would be some suspenseful music.
Oh, that's the stuff that really gets your heart pounding.
I would say so.
So far, all of these books are sounding really good and adventurous, which is what I'm always looking forward to. Okay.
Jessica, how are you feeling overall so far?
I'm a little confused on Sarah's book, but it sounds very interesting. Stars sounds kind of whimsical and maybe, although it's a rough ride, it sounds like the music would be interesting. Amanda's scares me a little bit. That music always gets my heart going in movies and gets my palms a little sweaty. So I'm not really sure where I'm leaning towards yet.
Okay. Are you ready for question number three?
Sure. All right, what is the toughest issue your character has dealt with in your book?
So mine deals with probably the roughest that anybody deals with, and that's death.
Ooh. Oh my, whimsical is going away.
Yeah, not really whimsical.
No, okay.
Mine has to deal with the inner demons of overcoming a tyrannical upbringing and a boarding school environment. But he's to be a good person, and he's having to hide his family's secrets and their plots of escape.
Ooh, that's really tough.
Those are some major issues to combat.
Yeah, so hiding secrets, and that is pretty tough. All right.
And my book has quite a few characters. It's not just one or two main characters, and they all have quite a few issues. Probably the toughest one that they're dealing with is also death and okay. Suspicion surrounding that. So.
Oh.
Heavy topic.
That sounds like a little bit of a mystery. Okay.
I could say that.
Yeah. I like a good mystery.
Jessica, are you ready for question number four?
Okay. Yes. If your book had a career, where would it work?
So my book would work in a hospital.
Oh. Okay.
With mine, I feel that mine would be a government career in a leadership role.
Your book is just getting even more exciting. Every time I come back to you, it sounds really good. I'm so far kind of leaning towards your book, Sarah. I like it.
All right, and mine would probably work in criminal law, maybe forensics or detective work.
Ooh, I do love that. Oh, forensics, anything that involves some science is pretty awesome. Okay.
How are you feeling, Jessica?
Good. I can't believe I only have one question left.
Okay, go ahead.
All right. Do any of your characters struggle with jealousy, anger, or other emotional issues?
So I have some minor characters in my book. One of them has PTSD. There are some other ones that suffer from abuse. I would say the main character is having issues with stress and fear and some anger and probably a little bit of depression.
Wow, they got a lot going on, and PTSD, that's very serious.
Yes.
Wow. I have no clue what your book is, though. Okay.
My main character has a shirt that he wears under his clothes. He has multiple versions of the same shirt. He wears it every single day to remind him to deal with the anger that he has hidden inside. So this shirt's hidden under his clothes just as he hides his anger within himself and keeps it bottled up so he doesn't explode.
Wow, there's some hidden meaning behind your character's intentions.
Hidden in his anger.
Mm-hmm.
Right, and mine, like I said, I have a number of characters in this book and they're all dealing with issues, so yes, all of the above. They have jealousy, anger, emotional issues. They have a lot going on.
Oh, your book is sounding really interesting too, and a lot of characters. I can get into a lot of characters. I like that.
Keeps you guessing.
It does. It really does.
Well, that's all the time we have for questions. Now it's time for our tech contestant, Jessica, to make her decision. But before we get her choice, let's hear a quick word from our sponsors. We're back. Thank you to our sponsors, and thank you to the great audience for supporting our show. Now, let's get back to Jessica's pick. Jessica, which book will be your next great read?
Well, this wasn't an easy choice. Both, I love Irish everything, so that got me with Star's book. But between Sarah and Amanda, the characters and where they're going, I guess I'm going to have to choose Sarah's book.
Wow, great choice. Before we reveal your winning book, let's meet the book you did not choose. Star, please reveal your book.
Hey, my book is The Pool of the Stars by Emma Donahue. It is about a nurse. Her name is Julia Power, and she is actually a certified and trained nurse who works at a hospital in Dublin, Ireland in 1918 during the big flu pandemic. And she usually works in maternity ward, but they have some pregnant women who have come down with the flu. So they made a separate little tiny ward for the pregnant women with the flu. And so they cleaned out kind of a supply closet and stuck a couple cots in there. And so she works there. She takes half a shift, like 12 hours, and a nun takes the night shift. And so she's trying to take care of these women, and they're trying to figure out, you know, what's going on with this flu and just all the rules in the hospital the nuns have. And she does know a lot about, you know, actual nursing and stuff that we might know now. But of course, some of the things they thought were different then. But, you know, they're trying to figure out how to deal with the flu and how to stop it from being transmitted. And she has a brother at home that she supports, that she lives with. He was in the war and he's suffering from PTSD and he's mute. He hasn't spoken since he's come home. So it just kind of, the whole book takes place over like 3 days and how she has to deal with the world that it is and shortages of space and shortages of staff and supplies in the hospital aren't there. And just, you know, how she has to deal with the emergencies that arise And, you know, it's just a matter of showing what humans can do, you know, when they have to, when it comes down to it.
Sounds like a really good book. Amanda, please reveal your book.
All right. My book is pretty new. It's a pretty new book called Not a Happy Family by Sherry LaPena. And in this book, I probably guess it is a kind of a mystery book. A very wealthy couple is murdered in their home, and they have several adult children who all have motive for wanting to see their parents dead. And there's also other friends and family members who have a cloud of suspicion around them. And of course, a police investigation unfolds, and there's twists and turns along the way until you finally find out what happened. So that's Not a Happy Family.
Sounds so interesting. I think I want to read that one too. And now it's time to reveal our winning book. Sarah, reveal your book, please.
It's the latest book by Mercedes Lackey, Beyond. She's gone back and she's writing prequels in the Valdemore series, and this is the creation or the founding of Valdemore. So it's Duke Valdemore that's the founder, and we're getting to see him before the land of Valdemore actually exists, that kingdom. And so we're starting out in the Empire, and we're finding out about how horrible and tyrannical the emperor was in that empire, and they needed to escape it to have a better life. And you have magic involved, and his family has been plotting to escape the empire for ages, but they've had to figure out how to create the magical spell to create a gate in order to go far enough away that they'll be able to escape the empire. And finally, in his lifetime, is when they discover the gate spell. But then you have other things happening. He suddenly gets called to go be at the capital. So instead of being able to help with all the preparations for leaving, he's actually in the heart of the empire, and he discovers these elementals that have been enslaved into dolls. And he decides not only to work to free his family and countrymen from the empire by escaping, but he vows to free the elementals to get them free as well. So, like I said, it fits with that protest song, because you've got him working against a form of slavery going on and just everything. It's just, you have ups and downs throughout the story, wondering who can he trust, who can't be trusted, all sorts of conspiracy things going on, things that you thought were true in the beginning, you learn in the end that some people that he thought were one way are another way. And it's like you're just wondering, is this really going to be the one that escapes or not?
Sounds like a really good attention. Fantastic. Jessica, are you happy with your choice?
Actually, I am. I do love a good fantasy read when I'm not reading nonfiction. So, and the fact I've never read Mercedes Lackey, now I'm very interested in picking up one of the books for her. That looks like a good book to read. Sounds really good.
Great. Another happy reader. Folks at home, you can check out any of these titles and thousands of other books and digital materials free with your library card. Check out our catalog online at www.librarysvisit.org. You can stop into any library branch, reserve items online, or just give us a call at 330-744-8636. You can even pick up materials curbside. Thank you everyone for joining us on Literary Love Connection. See you next time. Bye.
Bye.